Hello friend, today we are going to discuss about Docker file. What is Docker file and how can we create it? How can we create image from Docker file? So let's begin. What is Docker file? Docker can build images automatically by reading the instruction from a Docker file. When we create a Docker file, so it execute and reading the all the instruction line by line and build the images from your Docker files. A Docker file is a text document that contain all the command a user could call on the command line to assemble an image. A Docker file is a text document that contain all the command of user could run on the command line to assemble an image. Docker build command is used to create image from Docker file. To create image from Docker file, we use Docker build command. You make sure when you create a Docker file, so your file name should be Docker file and D should be caps. When you create any Docker file in any system, any machine, so you must show that Docker file name should be Docker file and D should be caps as it mentioned on your screen. Docker file components. And let's see and let's move on our Docker file components. What is the Docker file components and how many Docker file components? From, make sure whatever in this video in the caps letter, so it should be in the caps letter when you write the Docker file command and Docker file code, it should be capital letter as I have written this just like a from should be in the capital when you write the Docker command. For base image, this command must be on top of the Docker file. Run, to execute command, it will create a layer in image. To run any command, we use the run command, run, and after that, suppose you have to update your system, so you will have to write in the Docker file run space apt, if you are using Ubuntu, so apt hyphen get space updates space hyphen y, so it will be update your system. Maintainer, author, owner or description, you will provide the author name, owner name and description through the maintainer keywords. Copy file from local system, Docker VM, we need to provide source and destination. We can't download file from internet and any remote repository. Make sure there is a two option, one is a copy and second is a add option. But in the copy and add have a difference. So copy have a copy file from the local system. It will copy any file from your local system to in Docker VM also it will be copied. And we need to provide source and destination also for that copy that file. But we can't download any file from the internet when you and we are using copy. And not from any remote repository such as a Docker repository. Yeah, Docker registry or Docker hub. Add is a similar to copy command, but it provide a feature to download file from the internet and also we extract file at Docker image site. Add is also similar. I told you earlier that copy and add both are similar, but there is a one different that copy use for the local system to copy any file from your system and from your Docker. But add command we used to use to download any files from the internet such as a Docker. From your Docker hub you have to download your images, so you can add and we can also extract file at Docker image site. Expose, to expose slash open, we can tell expose and open, but we have to write expose means Docker never get any IP address whenever we create any container. So container have no IP address. When container have no any IP address, so it how can it communicate with your physical server, with your physical host operating system? How can you access your container application from outside the network? So in that case we open ports. Through the ports we can access your Docker file, Docker container application from outside the network. So in that case we need to be open the ports. So in that case we use expose, to expose and open ports such as a port 8080 for Tomcat and port 80 for Nginx. So these kinds of port can be opened when you create a Docker file. So by default, you define that we expose this port, so it will be open and you can access your resource file or application through that port. Workdir. Workdir means working directory, to set working directory for a container. CMD, execute command but during container creation. Suppose you want to execute some command when you container creation, so you can use CMD. In that case, CMD will execute during the container creation time. Entry point. Entry point is a similar to CMD command, but it is a higher priority over the command, and first command will be executed by the entry point when you create any container. So entry point, if you have mentioned in your Docker, so entry point will be executed first over, you can set up, after that CMD command will be executed. ENV, it is a environment variables. So these are the component of Docker file. You must be know about all these things then when you create a Docker files. Let's move and we see that how can we create a Docker file and how can we create an image from Docker file. So Docker command to create image from Docker file. Firstly, create a Docker file on Docker engine and make sure the file name should be Docker file, as I earlier told you. Write some code in Docker file as mentioned below. As your wish, whatever you want to do, write code. You can write code according to you, but here we are showing some example. So in that case, our first keyword, some reserved keyword, you can say that from's always written in the caps letter and should be top of the every in the Docker file. To use means install the base images. What will be our base images? Ubuntu colon latest means latest version, tag number, latest is a tag. And run when we execute any command, so apt-get update run apt-get install -y git. If we want to install git during the container, so it will be installed during the making container. Run apt-get install -y vim. -y vim. Why is when vim installed, so it will ask for yes or no. So it will not ask when you have mentioned already yes. So in that code, what we are doing? Firstly, we are installing base operating system from components. So we are using installing Ubuntu base operating system from latest. After that, we are updating our system from run component apt-get updates. After that, we are installing git and vim. After that, what we have to do? We have to save our file and exit from editor. To create image from Docker file, what you have to type the command? You have to type command docker space build space hyphen t space ons slash ubuntu colon v1 space fit dot means current directory where you have to build your image. So you have to type here and your image will be stored there. So we are using our current directory for dot is our denote for current directory. You have to remember always when you create any images from your Docker file, so command should be docker space build for using any images from Docker file. Hyphen t means we are giving tag name. ONS is just like a, suppose if you have a, we are giving a images name, you can say that. So these are the scenario for creating a Docker file image. So we will do practical some later. So there is some other topic which should be know. I think you must be know about this thing. So that's why we are moving on that. To check Docker images, which should you create recently? Docker image space images hoga. That's not good. Images should be. Difference between Docker attach and Docker ESEC. The Docker ESC create a new process in the container's environment, while Docker attach just connect the standard input output of the main process inside the container to corresponding standard input output error of current terminal. What is the difference between both Docker attach and Docker exe? Whenever you are using Docker exe, so it will be create always a new environment. Whatever you have done previously, it will not show. It will be open new terminal and will be look like a fresh. But when you use Docker attach, so it will be just connect and you can say that you will enter in your Docker container. But in the Docker exe, you will enter in the Docker container, but in the fresh window, not as you previous left. Docker exe is specially for running new thing in a already started container, be it a shell or some other process. There is another one thing that you must be know, difference between expose and publish a Docker. You have a three option, neither specify expose nor hyphen p. As I earlier told that expose we are using to open the port. Only specify expose and hyphen p. So what are the three conditions? We will deeply know about that. If you specify neither expose or nor hyphen p, the service in the container will only be accessible from inside the container itself. Means if you not configure any expose and not hyphen p, means you are not opening port, so in that case you can't access the any container from outside. You can access container inside itself. If you expose a port, the service is the in the container is not accessible from outside Docker. If you expose a port, if you open any port, the service in the container is not accessible from outside Docker, but from inside the Docker and other Docker container can access that service. So this is a good for interconnect container communication. If you want to communicate between two Docker containers, so it is a good thing that you have to open the expose port in that service. But in that service your container cannot be accessed from outside the Docker, but it can be accessed between two Docker containers. If you expose and hyphen p a port, the service in the container is accessible from anywhere, even outside the Docker. This is a major difference. You must be know about the what is the difference between attach and Docker exe. What is the service? Why we use exe and why we use attach? What is the difference between expose and publish? You must be know about these things. So let's move on our practicals. We have already opened our Ubuntu server where we have installed Docker in our previous video. So let's do some practical which we have see that how can we create image from the Docker file. So I am here logging on from root access. So what we have to do, we have to create firstly a Docker file. So where we are using nano to create a file, name is Docker file. Okay. And what we are going to do, firstly we have to write from space Ubuntu latest. Okay. After that we have to type run space apt get update. After that we have to what? We have to install git apt get hyphen y install git. What we have to do? Install hyphen y git, run apt get install hyphen y vim, save this file. Yes, okay. How to create images from Docker file? So firstly we have to check that we have any Docker images or not. So Docker images, we will check that they in our system there is a no Docker images. So right now we are going to create a Docker images from Docker file. So what is command? Docker build hyphen t ons slash ubuntu v and current directory dot. After that we will press enter. So you will see the here that sending build context to Docker daemon 1.693 MB. step 1, we have given 4 step, what? From run, 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 3 times run. So it's step 1, it's installing base Ubuntu system latest, pulling from library Ubuntu. It is pulling from Docker Hub. So it is installing firstly your Ubuntu, and now second task is run apt get updates. So it is going to update our containers. After that, what will be the third process is run. You can see here, and so it is going to install, I think, git. You will see after later that we have installed git or not when we create a container from images. Right now we are creating images from Docker file, so it will take some time because we have given 4 command to in this system, so it will take some time. Fourth command is going to run. It is installing Vim. Now successfully built Docker images. If you are going to type Docker images, so you will see here one images which name is ons/ubuntu and second is Ubuntu which download from command, with from command to in our components in our from Docker file. So that's why there is a two images. First is Ubuntu and second is ons/ubuntu. Tag name is we have given in this command. If you see my command, what we have right here, yes, v is a version tag number. So we have written v, that's why it's showing here v. Now we have to make container from our images. So how can we make container from our images? We have to type docker run hyphen it space name. What we are going to give our name of container, ons space what we have images, we have a ons, now we have given, and press enter. So what we are doing here, unable to find images, ons/latest. So what we have to do, we have to write here v also, enter. So now you can see that container has been created and we are entered in the container. This is our container ID. So we can check here that we have installed git or vim or not. So if we go here and type vim version, we can open file from the vim. Okay, so what we have to do, q enter. We have installed git or not, git version, yes, we have installed git 2.25.1. when we create images from Docker file, so it is install everything what we have command given in the Docker file. So now it's has been done. We need to be exit, and I hope that how can we create images from Docker file you have heard, and how can we create Docker container from images you can see in this video. I hope this video is helpful for you. So please subscribe our channel and hit the bell icon to get more updates. Thanks for watching.